is a hard game, don't you blame. It's your chance to arise your aim. Let your spirit be brave, always fight to hold your name. No matter how bad or rough, you never surrender.
Backup for what? Aming, are you telling me I'm incapable of dealing with Bruce Lee, huh?
Of course not, Master.
Anybody home?
May I help you, sir?
Yes. I'm looking for Mr. Lee.
Oh, and you are?
I'm Mr. Wang.
Oh, please come in.
Thank you.
Hai Quan. Someone's here to see you. You have a guest waiting.
All right. Did he tell you who he is?
It's Wang Li Chao.
Came here to see me?
Come on.
Isn't that strange? There must be an urgent reason for him to come here. Greetings, Mr. Wang. Welcome to our most humble abode.
Oh dear.
Sit down.
I'm sorry to disturb your sleep.
Sit down, sir. Over there.
No, you go first. Sit down.
Do sit down, sir, please.
Go ahead, you go first. Sit first, then I will.
All right, thanks. Would you like some tea, Mr. Wang?
It's all right, you first.
What about the cigarette?
It's all right, I've quit.
Really? Yes, now you will relax and sit down. Rick will see her. That's a generous thing to say. Thank you, Mr. Wang.
So what were showing last night at the theater?
We did excerpts of Shu Wei Pingui and Wang Baocheng.
Now that's a great play. I just never get tired of watching it. Your odor is perfect for you. All right, let's make a deal. If you should decide to do that performance again, tell me about it and I'll take my guys along to watch you. We're going to give you an applause you'll never forget.
Oh, why, of course, Mr. Wang.
Just a small gift.
Oh, Mr. Wang, thank you. But I can't accept another gift, it's too much. You've already sent me an apology letter, money, and now you're giving me another gift? Mr. Wang, you have nothing to worry about. I'm willing to pay you the amount you need to protect the theater.
I know. Sit down.
All right. You know, Mr. Wang, I appreciate what you're doing here. I'm sure it's not easy to maintain the peace and order in this neighborhood.
Someone here is aware of that. You're smart. That's why I've always admired you. And I can tell that your son will turn out to be a fine man like you.
Mr. Wang, your praise overwhelms me. Is there a particular reason for this visit?
Am I not welcome to visit? Huh?
No, of course you are.
You may not know this, but I've always wanted to pay a friendly visit. You throwing me out for not coming sooner?
Of course not. Mr. Wang, you will always be welcome in my house. And if I can help you in any way, don't hesitate to ask for my assistance.
Ah, good. Actually, you might be able to help. You see, I have this group of brothers who used to work for a living. Doing some security work. You know, patrolling all the commercial areas around, as well as protecting the peace in our neighborhood. At first, we didn't want to charge any fees. It's a bother, right? The thing is that they're all the breadwinners of their families, so they all need an income, right?
Sure.
And those businessmen, they used to spare them a tiny share. It's the kind of amount that you would give to beggars. Then Bruce suddenly comes up and warns my boys to stop asking for money. Maybe you just got the wrong idea about us.
You mean my son got involved and threatened your guys?
It's all right.
Boy's really going to get it. Don't worry, Mr. Wang. I'm going to teach him a lesson he won't forget.
What? Oh, come on. Don't be so hard on the boy, Mr. Lee. And besides, that's not the reason why I'm here. Actually, I have one simple request.
What?
I'm going to have a special banquet prepared at the Night Pearl Hotel in honor of a very special man. And that man is you. Imagine us with your fellow artists in the ballroom. Dining, drinking, and dancing away. To be the talk of the town. To be adored as a celebrity. That would be wonderful, right?
Mr. Wang, that's so flattering. I'm so flattered.
I have to go. There. This is just a simple gift, all right?
I can't take this.
It's yours. I'll see.
All right. Thank you for coming.
See that? This is all Bruce's fault.
All right. I'm fine. We can both go home now.
All right. You take care of yourself.
You sure you'll be okay?
Okay, goodbye.
Bye.
Hold on. Where have you been? Huh? I asked you a question. Answer me.
Hey, Ma. You know what the business owners called me? Their god of protection. They called me a god. They would put up a monument for me. Pa. Imagine a monument. Just for me. I want the whole of Hong Kong. And the whole world to know who Bruce Lee really is. They'll all recognize me as their god of protection. Why is everybody quiet? Huh? Pa, what's the problem?
Do you see this problem you're causing here? Huh? Do you want all of us to get into trouble?
Pa, I don't want to see anyone hurt. I'm doing this to protect everyone. Pa, I can't stand living in constant fear. I just can't. I want to stand out from the rest and live with pride and dignity. Pa, I can't live your life and praise those who don't deserve it. No way, Pa. I just can't.
For what you did, I got this. It was Wan Li Chao who gave it.
Wan Li Chao? He came here? Do you know what kind of a man he is? When he invited me to dinner, he berated a man by pouring a pot of boiling soup on him. Wan Li Chao, Wan Li Chao. Don't be scared of him. He's nothing to be afraid of.
Just talk to him tomorrow. Bring your brother upstairs. That's too bad.
What are you still doing here? Go to your room.
All right. Hold on, Curls. Let's stay in my room. Let him worry about it.
Wan Li Chao! You tried to buy my father with this?
Now, Bruce. Your father is a wonderful man who I've always regarded very highly. I just paid him a friendly visit yesterday. Why would I threaten him in any way? You've got a wrong idea.
Really?
What did you do that for? That was valuable.
Then you keep it. We don't need your gifts.
Should we get him? But that brat is getting arrogant.
Yes. I'll finish him off. Slip can cause more trouble. You boys want to give me more problems here? Maybe I should just stop looking after you guys. Yeah. I'm getting fed up with all this. Maybe I should just hand you over to the cops and just let you rot in jail, huh?
Xiaoman!
Oh, hi, Bruce. Did I take too long to come out?
Not really.
The guy they chose to play Xiaoping is just stupid. He couldn't even remember his own lines earlier. The director would have been pleased if you played the part.
You naughty girl. I knew there was another reason why you wanted me to fetch you here tonight. You just want me to play that husband part.
That's right.
Look, Xiaoman, since my father and my master won't have me as your bodyguard, I'll be your bodyguard instead and watch over you every day. How about that, huh?
Sure.
Shall we?
Come on. Let's race.
All right.
Hey, come back here!
Bruce!
But call
Bruce!
For help. Call for help!
Bruce! Oh no, he's hurt! Bruce!
Dong Yao. You look disturbed.
We just received terrible news.
What happened?
Xiaoman was run over.
What? I want both of you to go there. Try to find out who did this to him. Help with the expenses. Go on now.
Yes, Master. By the way.
Master, the job's already done. Bruce Lee's finished.
Good job, Alia. Very good. Where's your helmet?
I lost it.
You lost
it? Yeah.
Young, you've made me very proud of you. Your dedication is to be admired by your fellow brothers.
Thank you, Master.
But for now, try not to say a word about this to anyone.
Yes, sir.
By the way, Al Young, I suggest that you burn those clothes you're wearing. If someone has witnessed the whole thing, their clothes would be the first thing they'd remember. So try to play it safe. All right? Tell me. How did you lose your helmet?
I forgot to strap it on, Master.
Your forgetfulness will put you in trouble.
I could go find it if you want, Master.
Never mind. Go and freshen up. I'll send a woman over to your room.
Thank you. Master, am I free to leave now? Thank you.
Had a talk with his doctor. He said that Bruce could stay in a coma due to cerebral hemorrhage.
What? Oh, my son.
Is it true that you met Bruce last night at the main theater? But what for? Why were you even there in the first place?
I joined the play. He knew about it. He didn't want me to be alone that late. So he picked me up. I never thought he'd end up in an accident. I'm so sorry.
All right, don't cry. I'm not blaming you for this. This wasn't just an accident. I know there's someone out there. Done this to Bruce in order to silence him for good.
Mr. Lee, who on earth would do that?
You know that Bruce has been protecting some businessmen here from paying extortion fees, right? Remember Mr. Kwan, who runs a business next to your father's shop? He died mysteriously when he refused to give them money.
You mean one of those thugs did this to him?
The police will be coming over to make an investigation. All I'm asking you is to recall every detail and tell them everything. I hope he gets caught. I really hope they catch him.
Xiaoman, would you be able to identify the biker who ran over your friend? Did you take a good look at him?
Well, I was looking at Bruce at that time. My attention was... Yes, His helmet flew off from the collision. His head was bald and seemed kind of scarred.
Thanks, Xiaoman.
Master, Bruce Lee's still alive at the hospital.
Are you sure, Aming?
I've just been there, Master.
He's still alive?
But I overheard he was in a coma. They believe it's permanent. The guy's a vegetable. Master, you no longer have anything to worry about. Your problem is solved.
And since when has Bruce become my problem? He was supposed to be your problem, right? Huh?
You're right. Forgive me, Master. He was our biggest problem, not yours.
Aming, has Aliang already found his lost helmet?
No, he hasn't. But relax, Master. With Bruce Lee disabled, no one would dare speak against us.
It's still better lost than found. If the authorities get a hold of him, then we wouldn't have too much of a problem. But if Master Yi gets him, he'll know who owns him. Followers won't stop until they get a hold of Aliang. And if he gets arrested and gets questioned, he'd be singing like a bird. Aming.
Yes, Master.
How should we deal with this kind of problem?
I'll do whatever you think is right.
I want to see how you think, Aming.
We let Aliang go into hiding. It'll be like admitting to the crime. But if he doesn't lie low...
Yes, go on.
I don't know what to do, Master.
Aming, son. I've always thought that you would be my successor someday. But if you don't have any idea on what to do in a case like this, then how can I have you take my place?
Did Aliang in. That would be too heartless.
That depends on how you look at it. If someone is endangering the welfare of our group, and you don't stop him to save the majority, then that's more heartless. Now, if you still don't know what should be done here, then you have turned out to be a big disappointment to me.
You mean I should have him killed?
If there was only some other way. Do what has to be done. I just feel sorry for the poor boy.
Get your act together.
Sure thing. What should be done?
Take that to Aliang. Hey. The master just said, dead men don't talk.
Leave it to me.
Here.
The
Master bought you a new set of clothes.
The man always keeps his word.
Try it on.
Yeah, later.
Come on, Elian. I just want to see you wear them. Nice fit.
What do you think?
Looks great. The master wants you to look good, even in death.
Woke up!
Hi, Bruce.
Ma, what am I doing here? Why is everybody making a big fuss? What's the big deal? All I remember is that I got hit by a motorcycle. Ma?
Does your head hurt, Bruce?
Yeah, a little. But I'm feeling better now. I just fell asleep is all.
You shouldn't be moving. Where does it hurt?
My hands and legs are feeling a little stiff. But I'm better, look.
No! Just get back in bed.
Stop moving around.
You see? I'm fine.
Come on. Lie down. The doctor said you shouldn't be moving around.
I'm fine.
If you want to live a long life, just lie there.
I'm fine.
I think that the best thing Bruce can do at the moment is to leave Hong Kong as soon as possible, Mr. Lee.
Right. I agree with Master Ye. My wife and I already talked about it. For his own safety, Bruce must leave Hong Kong right away.
Then in that case, let me make the arrangements.
Yes, thank you.
Master, I have news. It's Bald Alian. He's dead.
What? Bald Alian is dead.
Why on earth isn't your father back home yet? Oh, so have you found out anything about who ran over Bruce?
Yes, I have. I'm just going to cut the story short, all right?
Okay.
It was Wang Lichao's man who ran Bruce down.
So, what? Why don't you have that man arrested?
Yes!
Because I can't. It's pointless now to do that. It was Ali Young who ran Bruce down. And now he was found dead. I suppose they decided to kill him to cover up the crime.
My goodness. But what should we do now, Haikuan?
It's all right.
Oh my goodness.
Calm down. You don't have to worry. I've already talked to Master Ye and James. Since those gangsters had to sacrifice one of their men, they'll surely make our son pay for that. We have to send Bruce to the States.
My son's going away?
Yes.
But he'll be alone there.
Honey, he won't be alone. James will come along, so you've nothing to worry about. They'll all set together as soon as Bruce recovers.
But Haikuan, this is all so sudden. There has to be some other way. There has to be.
Oh, come now. This is not the time to cry. This is the only solution we have to save Bruce. Now listen to me, all right? I know how much you love Bruce. And I know that you wouldn't want him to live too far away from you. But he's in danger here. If there was only some other way to keep him here, I would have chosen that. It also breaks my heart to do this. What?
America. It's so far, Haikuan. It's too far.
Just calm down. Calm down. Here.
Yes?
Go to my room and bring this small trunk out here.
Okay.
Listen to me. This could be a chance for Bruce to change his ways and to do a lot better in life. Living in the U.S. would do him good. You have a lot of opportunities there. I know that he's going to excel. As a father, I want to give him a chance to start his own life and decide for himself. If we keep him here, our son is never going to have that. He's too idealistic. And with that temper he has, he'll always wind up in trouble. That's why we'll have to be strong. For our son's sake. Come on, stop crying. You've always been a tough girl. Right? And you've nothing to worry about. Since James will be with our son. Huh? I'm sure he's going to be all right.
Yes. I know he'll be safe there with James. I have to be strong about this.
Yes.
But when will he be back here? What if we don't ever see him again?
Now don't you talk like that. I know he'll come back to us someday.
Here it is, Pa.
Thanks. Come on.
What is it?
Look at it.
What's this?
That's what Bruce earned when he was still a child actor. I had it exchanged into U.S. dollars because I figured that it might be useful to him someday. Okay. Like they say, practice thrift at home, but be amply provided in travel. And he's going to need it. I'm sure that's going to be more than enough. Just to keep him going in the States. Again? How did you manage
to? 'Cause I'm tough. Now tell me, who's the guy who ran me over? Did you give him the order to do it?
Bruce, please. I don't even know what you're talking about, son.
If you're not going to tell me who he is, and you refuse to admit to the deed, then you're going to die here!
That's all.
all right. Listen, Bruce. I'd never even dream of doing that. Come, let's talk this over inside, all right? Let's talk. Well, come on, it's okay. Nobody should come inside unless I call for you, you hear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Well, come in. Now, Bruce, let's not get hasty. We can settle this once and for all.
I intend to.
Whoever you are, do you have to call at such an ungodly hour?
Yes, Superintendent. I'm sorry to have disturbed you at this time.
Who is this?
It's me, Wang Li Chao.
Elder brother,
is there something you need?
Actually, there was a man who attacked me here in my own home.
Is that so? Well, just leave it to me. I'll have him arrested. Just give me his name, and I'll have him picked up as soon as possible. Don't you worry. We'll have him picked up before he can escape.
The man's name is Bruce Lee. Thank you, Superintendent.
Come on, hurry up.
Oh, sir. Alert the third team at once. We've been assigned to catch a notorious thug.
Who is it?
His name is Bruce Lee. Find out everything you need to know about him.
But...
do it immediately.
Okay, sir. Right away, sir.
This is going to be a tough job, but we're going to get it done! Our master got beaten up because we were incompetent. We have brought shame to him. And now that he's given us an order, we're going to do this right. And we're going to get it done, no matter what it takes. Am I clear? We have to prove to him that we can do this.
Right.
You all have your weapons there?
Got your weapons?
Yeah,
we do.
I got mine.
Let's go.
This is Li Haikuan. Oh, yes, go on. I'm listening. All right. Yes, I got it. Thanks.
Well, who was it? Well, was it Wang Li Chao who called? Haikuan, was it Wang Li Chao?
This is such a mess. He wants Bruce arrested. Peter, take your family and stay with your in-laws. Leave while you can. You take care now. Oh. Come here.
The police are already underway here.
It's all right, Pa. Let them come. I've nothing to be afraid of. It's Wang Li Chao they should be arresting.
We're not going to have a discussion about who's right or wrong here. That won't matter because the police chief is Wang Li Chao's friend. Can't you see they're on the same side? That was James who just called up. And he heard you were getting arrested from Ma Chang, who's one of his students.
The policeman?
Right. You're lucky he's decided to take your side and told James about it. Go with Zhongliang before the police arrive to arrest you. Come on. They'll help you out. Hide somewhere.
Wait. Where can they go at this time of night?
They'll figure it out. When the police arrive, tell them Bruce got injured and was rushed to the hospital. Don't say anything more than that, okay? Come on. Let's go.
Bruce.
Hurry up.
Come on. Hurry. This way. Hurry up.
Quiet.